Northern California's first primetime news. This is Fox 40 News.
She heard him coming up behind her. She heard footsteps faster than hers.
An attacker gives a woman a shocking surprise in this Valley City, and tonight the suspect is still on the loose. Good evening, everyone. I'm Donna Cordova.
And I'm Thomas Drayton. Thanks for joining us. Davis police need your help tonight. They are trying to find a man who attacked a UC Davis student with a stun gun. Fox 40's Christina Warner is live at the Davis Police Department following this story for us tonight. What's going on, Christina?
Thomas, the attack happened early this morning. The victim is okay, but the suspect is still on the loose.
Yeah, that's really scary. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Word of a stun gun attack is rattling nerves in the usually quiet city of Davis.
I don't think that in Davis we've had the use of a stun gun in an attack like this.
Early this morning, a 21-year-old Davis woman was attacked right here near the corner of 3rd and L Streets. She was walking alone to a friend's house.
Somebody came up behind her. She felt hands on her shoulders, and then they applied a stun gun, which she didn't actually see, but by everything she heard and felt, we believe that's what the suspect used.
The victim fell to the ground, but was able to fight the suspect off.
And she started kicking him, and he basically fled once she started to fight back.
Despite a few scrapes, the young woman is okay, and she did get a good look at her attacker.
This did happen right under a streetlight, so she got a good look at his face.
Police have this composite. The suspect is described as a white male in his mid-20s, about 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighing 160 pounds. Lieutenant Turay is hoping someone will come forward with information. She says this is a good reminder for everyone to stay alert.
Travel in groups, be aware of your surrounding, walk with your head up, look confident, look like you're paying attention.
All right, I want to give you another chance to look at the suspect. He's described as a white male, 5 feet, 8 inches tall, about 160 pounds, very short hair. He was wearing jeans and a white T-shirt. If you have any information, you are urged to call the Davis Police Department. Reporting live in Davis, I'm Christina Werner, Fox 40 News.
A volunteer coach with the Solano County Special Olympics spent time in jail today accused of sexually molesting a 21-year-old woman he coached. Fox 40's Lonnie Wong tells us the charges being levied are disturbing for everyone involved.
Set.
Special Olympics events like this allow mentally disabled athletes to showcase their skills and overcome obstacles with the help of volunteers. But police say volunteer coach Robert Jacobson took advantage of a 21-year-old woman who has the mental capacity of a 10-year-old.
She was very upset. She understood something bad had happened to her.
Police arrested the 58-year-old Jacobson at his Susun home where he lives with his wife and two children. The father of the alleged victim, who didn't want to be identified, says Jacobson was a trusted special education aide when he introduced them to Special Olympics.
The trust that I once had for this individual right now has pretty much been diminished.
The case hits home for Fairfield police officers, longtime supporters of the Special Olympics.
This is comes as a great shock to us. We're very disturbed by it.
Police say he lured the woman to this Fairfield storage facility used by the Special Olympics, saying he needed help to move equipment. That's when detectives say he exposed himself and molested her. Police investigators say Jacobson broke a key policy of the Special Olympics that none of their staff ever be alone with any of their clients. Rachel Ford is the director of a support agency for the mentally disabled. She says they place all their trust in caregivers like Jacobson.
The more you have to trust them, the more likely you are to be vulnerable to their inappropriate advances.
The police and the woman's father urge any other victims of sexual abuse to come forward.
There has to come an end to this stuff. People like that have to be stopped.
In Fairfield, Lonnie Wong, Fox 40 News.
A Sacramento man accused of sexually assaulting an 8-year-old boy made his first court appearance today. 39-year-old Pablo Valle did not enter a plea. He is charged with kidnapping and committing a lewd act with a child under 14. Authorities say Valle befriended the boy here at Rainbow Park in South Sacramento by giving him gifts and money. They say Valle then lured the boy into his vehicle and drove him to another location where deputies say he sexually assaulted him.
Fresno County Sheriff's detectives have located the body of 4-year-old Cassandra Hodges. Cassandra's mother, 20-year-old Amanda Hodges, appeared in court today hours after leading authorities to a shallow grave in Oregon where the girl's body was covered with garbage bags. Hodges admitted to killing her daughter after initially telling detectives the girl disappeared at a Fresno area flea market. An autopsy found the girl had been hit in the head and abdomen. Prosecutors getting a boost today in the Scott Peterson murder trial. For the fifth day, Modesto Police Detective Alan Bershini took the stand. He testified that Peterson explained to a friend in detail 9 years ago about how he would dispose of a body if he killed someone. The friend says the method Scott described was exactly the way Lacey's body was found. Detective Bershini told the court he didn't include this in his report because he felt the friend was not credible. Prosecutors say that admission proves Modesto detectives were not out to get Peterson like the defense claims.
Residents in One Oak Park neighborhood are fed up tonight. They say blight from illegal dumping in their streets is at an all-time high and that the county isn't doing enough about the problem. Fox 40's Michelle Kennedy is live in our newsroom with that story. Michelle?
Well, Donna, the neighborhood we visited today is home to some huge piles of junk. Now, the county is supposed to come and pick it up within 5 days of hearing about it. Residents say that isn't happening.
Vacuums, chairs, garbage can.
Trenton Lamone knows this pile of junk very well.
I see tires, open nails, clothes.
It sits right in front of his family's home.
1 week it's gone, then the next week it's back somehow.
Trenton isn't the only one watching people leave trash around here.
They opened a fence, backed up into the property, dumped, and then they left, like it's a city dump.
Most people can't figure out why the county doesn't pick this stuff up more often.
They usually clean up maybe once or twice a month, but then after that, they start it back again.
Residents on 45th Street and 15th Avenue in Oak Park say they simply aren't being heard. It's no secret this area sees its share of crime and other problems on a daily basis. That's why people around here believe the county has already written this neighborhood off.
It's like a broken window. If you leave that broken window, everything else just happens and it goes downhill. And that's one of those things. You want to fix it up and get rid of the blight down here. It's a good area.
Abandoned cars are another big problem. The question is, what is the county doing about all this?
We clean up sites regardless of where they are when people notify us.
According to municipal services, no one has notified the county about trash problems in this neighborhood since March. Calling the county is the best thing people can do because abatement crews won't come to pick this up until a complaint is made.
So it's a pretty big job, and what we need is that people to tell us where these sites are so we come out and clean them, and we'll do it in about 5 days.
So here is the number to call to report trash being dumped illegally in the county. It's 916-875-5656. If the situation allows, an officer will actually be sent out at the time of the call to try to arrest the dumper. The trash that we showed you today is supposed to be picked up tomorrow. Reporting live in the newsroom, Michelle Kennedy, Fox 40 News.
All right, Michelle, and we'll keep everyone updated. The Sacramento City Council could decide tonight whether to take the next step towards building a new sports arena. Council members are expected to direct top managers to craft ballot language for two measures that would be placed on the November ballot. One would propose an expansive downtown sports entertainment district, including the arena. The other would offer a more limited plan to build only a new arena in North Natomas. Using eminent domain, Stockton City Council voted tonight to acquire several area businesses.
It's all to make room for a multi-million dollar sports complex. But as you can imagine, not everyone is pleased with this decision. Fox 40's Melissa Remick joins us live from downtown Stockton with more. Melissa?
Hi, Thomas. Across this waterway, they have already broken ground on that sports and entertainment complex. And while they have plenty of room for the complex itself, developers decided they still needed room for parking. You don't have to look far to see that Stockton is in the midst of a transformation, which includes a new arena, baseball stadium, conference center, and retail establishment. Across the street, though, a business that has served Stockton for decades, a business that developers say would better serve the public as a parking lot.
You almost can't fight the city, it seems like. You know, they're using this intimate domain as a power thrive. And it's working.
Tim Wilhite owns Butch Young Fire Equipment, a family business run by three generations of Wilhite men. According to this Stockton native, the city offered him $104,000 for his property. So at a city council meeting tonight, the family's attorney spoke out.
A lot of people have been going to get their fire extinguisher serviced in this business for over 17 years. And frankly, all my clients have seen is a ridiculous offer. Back in October.
Wilhite's property, one of five sites affected by redevelopment.
At today's real estate market, you can't buy a two-bedroom home for $180,000. And what they've offered me recently is not fair at all, I think.
But despite the pleas, council voted unanimously to acquire the properties through eminent domain. Mayor Podesta stressing, though, that he wanted to keep price negotiations open.
Now, so far, the folks that we have moved for the Cineplex and all those are doing way better than they were
Much better off.
Yeah.
We enjoy our work. We enjoy the people. And I think most of the people, they enjoy us.
And Earl Wilhite hopes he can still keep it that way. And the mayor requested new land appraisals tonight, and he wants to be updated in 2 weeks. In the meantime, the complex is scheduled to open fall of 2005. Live in Stockton, Melissa Remick, Fox 40 News.
Certainly follow this one, Melissa. Thank you. Some good news here. Crews are a lot closer to fixing that big levee break in the Delta.
Wait till you hear how close. That story is coming up. Also ahead. A bank robbery in progress with suspects armed to the teeth, and it's all caught on tape. Plus,
a first-of-its-kind law goes into effect in California Wednesday, benefiting parents, spouses, and caregivers.
And the mother of a local soldier killed in Iraq has begun a crusade that may raise some eyebrows.
Strong Delta breeze really taking a bite out of our temperatures today. We also had more thunderstorms up in the Sierra. That trend set to continue. We'll talk about that and how it may affect your holiday weekend coming up.
John McEnroe's latest tennis match on a floating court on the River Thames.
You cannot be serious!
Oh, but we are. I'm Jim Crandell. The story ahead in sports.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Sleep Train Mattress Centers, your ticket to a better night's sleep.
The summer is heating up. And Fox Wednesday, the big funny is the hottest night of comedy of the new season.
It's going to be so bright that they're going to be wearing shades on Uranus.
That 70s show.
Hi, boys.
Quintuplets.
Our little circus monkey is going to tumble his way right into college.
Simple Life 2.
Play the face like you love it.
And Method and Red. Get your laugh on with the big fun
Wednesday starting at 8 on Fox 40.
What does a Toyota Highlander have in common with Universal theme parks? They're both known for great rides. Kids love them both. And they both make every day an adventure. Visit Universal Orlando or Universal Hollywood. And do it in a Highlander. That way, the fun starts on the drive over.
So, did you hear?
Hear what?
Sadie made a break for it.
No way.
She's heading to California.
Hey, Sadie's going to California.
She's going to California.
Sadie's going to California.
When did she leave?
2 days ago.
Well, she is facing a bit of a headwind.
Yeah.
Great cheese comes from happy cows. Happy cows come from California. Real California cheese.
Dodge June bonus days are almost over, and now you've only got 1 week to deal. Get an additional $1,000 June bonus cash for a combined cash allowance of up to $4,500 on select models for qualified buyers who finance through Chrysler Financial. Or get 0% financing with $1,000 in bonus cash. Plus, with 1 week to deal, come in now and make no monthly payments until 2005. June bonus days are ending, and you've only got 1 week to deal, so get to your Dodge dealer today.
Hit it! No sales tax event, July 10th at Cope and McFeeters in Rockland and Tahoe.
Fox 40 News at 10 continues.
Crews are making progress on a fire threatening homes in the Sierra. It's north of Colville, which is right near the California-Nevada border off I-395. The fire closed the freeway for hours, but it's been reopened. Everyone's worried about the Marine Corps housing unit there, which was evacuated. There's just smoke all around the area. The fire has burned some 900 acres, but crews say thanks to lower temps and higher humidity, they do have the fire a third of the way surrounded. Placer County Sheriff's officials are trying to positively identify a man who drowned in the river at Auburn State Park. Dive teams recovered the man's body early this morning where the south and the middle forks of the American River meet. Park officials say the victim had been swimming when he yelled to friends that he was drowning. He then went under. The man was from LA and spoke only Spanish.
An overturned big rig caused a major backup on a southbound Interstate 5 today. It took several hours for crews to move this rig out of the way, causing problems for noontime commuters. CHP officials say the big rig was taking the on-ramp to Highway 50 when it overturned. Luckily, no one was injured. Check out the path of destruction left behind after a truck caused a 10-car accident in Los Angeles today. The CHP says the truck plowed down a freeway off-ramp, sideswiping a car before barreling around a bend and ramming several other cars waiting at a stoplight. The truck then jumped the center divide, skidded across a road, stuck a light pole and a fire hydrant before coming to a rest. Seven people were injured, one critically.
Officials expect to have that levee break at the Delta filled in by Saturday. That would be 1 month after the Jones Track levee crumbled, flooding some 12,000 acres of farmland. The fix is taking more than 180,000 tons of rock. Then they'll cover the site with soil and pump out the water. It's believed that the area could be crop ready by mid-October. A $207 million project to modify Folsom Dam officially began today. The improvements are part of a larger $850 million plan to strengthen the area's flood control system over the next 15 years. The project will enlarge eight existing outlets and add two more in order for the dam to release water faster if there is a flood. The dam's wall will also be raised 7 feet.
California enters uncharted territory Thursday, becoming the only state with a paid family leave law. As Fox 40 Shanna Franklin reports, 3,000 employees have applied for the program, which will allow them to take roughly 50% of their salary for up to 6 weeks.
When Penny, Sylvia, and her husband had their first child, Isabel, 2 years ago, they faced the usual stress and more.
I'm the breadwinner of our family, so I had to work and worry and save.
She took 6 weeks off, but without pay. That part will soon change for the Sylvia family and millions of others under California's new paid family leave law.
Well, I get to be a mom and not have to worry about my job.
Dozens of supporters, including Penny Sylvia, came together at a news conference today held by one of the law's supporters. They say it will benefit families who need time off to bond with a new child or care for a sick child, spouse, or parent.
Our survey found that 85% of the respondents favored such a law.
But not the California Chamber of Commerce. It's a longtime outspoken critic along with many businesses.
Well, there's a lot of problems with the paid family leave.
The chamber says the new law will burden employees who aren't guaranteed their jobs and cripple small businesses.
If you only have 5 to 10 workers and two people take off at any given time, extended time off, unscheduled time off, you have 10 workers, it's very difficult to manage your workforce.
But supporters fire back, saying the biggest negative they see is just 22% of people surveyed were even aware this law existed.
Scientists show us very clearly that the connections that mothers and fathers make with their children in the first few months of life has a profound effect on how that child's brain is organized.
In Sacramento, Shanna Franklin, Fox 40 News.
State budget talks continue tonight as legislative leaders try to reach a deal before the new fiscal year begins on Thursday. Party leaders from both houses met with Governor Schwarzenegger twice today to discuss the last unresolved issues in the budget, including money for state universities and home health care workers' wages. The governor also announced today that he's close to an agreement with the state's prison guard union that would save $108 million over 2 years.
A boost for charter schools in the state. Governor Schwarzenegger was joined by educators and students today as U.S. Education Secretary Rod Page delivered a $24.7 million check in support of charter schools during a ceremony at Sacramento High School.
There is no issue, I think, that is more important than education for our children. I always say that the children should have the first call on our treasury.
The money is part of a $75 million commitment to the state's charter school program and will be used to develop 250 new charter schools by the year 2007.
A Valley mother who lost a son in Iraq is planning a protest campaign.
And we will have that story for you in just 5 minutes. Plus, the U.S. prepares to hand over Saddam Hussein to the Iraqi people. And
they are very serious allegations and very concerning allegations.
Find out why police busted this TV color analyst for a pro basketball team.
Join Fox 40 as we celebrate America with a spectacular fireworks display at Sunrise Mall. Free parking and free admission throughout Sunrise Marketplace. Enjoy music by Clean Slate starting at 7:15 behind Sears. Then fireworks at dusk. Look for Fox 40's Road Crew and get your free 3D fireworks classes. July 4th, fireworks at Sunrise Mall and Sunrise Marketplace. For details, log on to Fox40.com.
I really like the Amante. It has so much room.
Yeah, but I love the Sorento. It's got the four-wheel drive.
Well, I don't know.
May I?
Okay.
Oh. Somebody likes the Sedona.
Kia is doing whatever it takes to help you get into a new car, like offering $2,000 cash back and our 10-year warranty on the kid-friendly Sedona. Visit your Valley Kia retailers. Hurry, offer ends June 30th.
Tough, 100% tender. Rancher's Reserve beef is the only beef that's guaranteed 100% tender and juicy every time. Rancher's Reserve, exclusively at Safeway.
Thinking about selling your car? Come to CarMax before you go anywhere else. We'll give you a free written appraisal of your car, good for 7 days or 300 miles, whether you buy a car from us or not. CarMax, the way car buying should be.
CarMax puts every car through a 125-point inspection. We check the transmission, the cooling system, and more than 20 points on the engine alone. So you get a car you can depend on. CarMax, the way car buying should be.
Some cars are just born to follow, one-dimensional, charisma-free. But this car has a different vibe. It takes any road you throw at it, and everything you throw in it. Runs fast between lights and long between fill-ups. Give it a destination and go where the vibe takes you. Non-GM owners and lessees can let a new Pontiac Vibe Western Edition take you wherever you'd like to go for around $16,200. See your Northern California Pontiac dealer today.
This portion of Fox 40 News is brought to you by Chevy Trucks.
Arrest warrants have been issued by the new Iraqi government for Saddam Hussein and 11 of his henchmen. Iraq is preparing to take legal custody of Saddam tomorrow with a very public court hearing set for Thursday. Fox 40's Grant Rampey has more tonight from the Pentagon.
For Iraq's new government, the first order of business is dealing with its former leader, a tyrant of the first order. Tomorrow, legal custody of Saddam Hussein and 11 of his top lieutenants will be transferred out of U.S. hands.
Those we believe most responsible for Iraq's suffering will face Iraqi justice.
Prime Minister Iyad Alawi promises justice will be done publicly, fairly, and as quickly as possible. First step, Saddam must face formal charges. Plans are to have him walk past cameras on his way into open court on Thursday, this despite fears that someone may use the opportunity to try to kill him or help him escape. The next step,
I would imagine some trials beginning early next year for some of the key defendants.
Other developments in Iraq, three Marines killed today by a roadside bomb, two others badly wounded. The Pentagon now confirms that Marine Corporal Wasif Hassoun has been captured. A video released by his captors shows him blindfolded with a sword held to his head. The president, meanwhile, says he hopes that not only the Iraqi people, but the entire Arab world will one day embrace democracy. Mr. Bush knows many Muslims identified with, quote, the worst of Western popular culture, with coarse videos and crass commercialism. But he says they shouldn't worry.
There is nothing incompatible between democratic values and high standards of decency.
Iraqi leaders hope that by showing Saddam on Thursday, being hauled into court like anyone else.
Thank you, Grant Rampey, reporting for us. The mother of a Tracy soldier who was killed in Iraq reportedly wants to start a group for mothers and families who are opposed to the war. Nadia McCaffrey watched her son's casket arrive at SAC International Airport Sunday night. She says she supports the military men and women who were in Iraq, but not the war itself. She also believes our troops are under-equipped and overworked out there. Army Specialist Patrick McCaffrey was killed last week during an ambush north of Baghdad.
Still to come tonight, another teacher is accused of having sex with an underage student.
Also ahead, a couple is charged with trying to sell their baby on a beach. And this is not a new water ride. Intense flooding. Actually, that is the incorrect video. We are going to tell you about the flooding at an amusement park.
There's the flooding video right there. A second ago, you saw some dramatic video of suspected serial bank robbers who were caught on camera pulling off their latest heist.
Also, we do have a reminder about the Fox 40 viewer's voice. If you have comments, questions, or news story ideas, please let us know. Log on to fox40.com and you can email us or call the viewer's voice phone line at 916-733-3151.
Why is the new Malibu LT such a great value? It has a standard 200 horsepower V6 engine with better fuel economy than a comparably equipped Camry and Accord. And it has exclusive features you can't get on either one. And the fact that Malibu's thousands less, well, we're kind of surprised you're still sitting there. Chevy Malibu. Turn the key and start a revolution. See your Northern California Chevy dealer.
When the wildfires hit, we weren't as prepared as we had hoped that we would be. So we scrambled, put together a shelter at the San Bernardino Airport. And Morongo showed up one day and actually served a Thanksgiving lunch to the people in the shelter at the San Bernardino Airport and provided a $1 million contribution for disaster relief within Riverside County. The Morongos were just sent from heaven to help the people who were displaced by the wildfires last fall. And I'm personally very impressed with what they did.
Jeep vehicle enthusiasts will be heading to California's first annual Camp Jeep soon. A weekend of off-road action, extreme sports, and live concerts exclusively for Jeep vehicle owners. Show up in anything else, and you won't get past the first obstacle. Bob.
Beep. Beep.
Hurry, June 30th is the last day qualified Californians make no payments till 2005 on Grand Cherokee and get $1,000 bonus cash when financing through Chrysler Financial. Then reserve a spot at Camp Jeep online.
Fox 40 News at 10 continues.
The fun has stopped at an amusement park in Arlington, Texas. You can clearly see the reason why. Heavy rains have caused extensive flooding. Part of the roller coaster right there is underwater. Six Flags is not the only location in Texas that is being hit hard by the torrential rains. Many sections in the northern part of the state are also flooded. Forecasters say another round of storms is expected tonight.
Tonight, police in Washington, D.C. are searching for serial bank robbers, and now we see just how brazen and dangerous this group really is. They robbed again today. As Mike Brooks shows us, a crew from the Fox television station there was working nearby and videotaped the men, their guns, and the getaway.
An unidentified woman walks past the SunTrust Bank on Upper Connecticut Avenue in Washington. She looks to her left and sees something near a green minivan that gets her attention. She plays it cool and then runs across the street. Moments later, a heavily armed man carrying what appears to be an AK-47 peeks around the corner of the bank and then gets back into that van. Then, two more heavily armed men emerge from the bank. One of the men is carrying a bag. The other loses his footing. The man quickly recovers and jumps into the driver's seat. The van cuts across Connecticut Avenue and speeds away from the scene. This is the same getaway van, several blocks away, going up in flames. Officials believe they then took off in another vehicle. Law enforcement authorities believe these may be the same men responsible for five other similar bank robberies in D.C. and Prince George's County, Maryland, since early January. Law enforcement sources close to the investigation tell me the robbers have set fire to two other getaway vehicles. So far, no one has been injured during the robberies, even though a gunman fired a shot in the bank in this most recent robbery. During robbery number four, the gunman fired at a Prince George's County police officer, narrowly missing her. The FBI is offering a $50,000 reward for their arrest. Mike Brooks, Atlanta.
And crooks are getting creative in Georgia. Someone made off with an ATM machine, not just the money, the entire back of the machine. All they did was hotwire a backhoe from a construction site across the street. The rest was just too easy.
I just saw it. I had no idea. And I asked them, I said, what happened? They said, somebody stole it. I said, how? With that machine.
Can you believe it? And police say someone used a tractor to hit another ATM 2 weeks ago. Now, they did get a picture of that robber, and judging by his hat, they believe he does work in construction.
Controversy tonight over a Supreme Court ruling regarding children in online pornography. The High Court ruled today that a 1998 law aimed at shielding children from online porn may be in violation of the First Amendment. Leaders from the Justice Department say the 5-4 decision goes against common sense and exposes children. Lawyers from the ACLU say the ruling preserves the right for adults to communicate with other adults without risking jail time. A New Jersey couple is in big trouble tonight after they were caught trying to sell their baby to beachgoers. Someone on the beach called police and told them the pair had stuffed their 4-month-old child in a duffel bag and were trying to sell it for the right price. Neighbors of the couple were shocked when they heard about all of this. They say they believe it may have been a joke.
They don't seem that type of people. They seem very religious. They were always like, God bless you. She went to parenting groups and they went to church on Sundays.
The infant has since been placed in state custody pending further investigation. The couple was released on $5,000 bail each.
A TV announcer for the Orlando Magic basketball team is accused of molesting a 14-year-old girl. 47-year-old Jack Givens was arrested after the team claimed Givens assaulted her several times at her home. Givens had gone to the house for a personal basketball coaching session. Givens insists nothing happened out there.
They are very serious allegations and very concerning allegations, no doubt about that. And I just hope that in the next couple of days, it's going to be put to rest.
Givens is out on $25,000 bail. He does have a wife and 2 children. Police in Florida busted a 23-year-old middle school teacher. She is accused of having sexual relations with a 14-year-old student. As Brian Todd reports, this case may remind you of a few other high-profile cases.
Her marriage and career just beginning, this 23-year-old remedial reading teacher is now at the center of a sordid case that swept through a huge Florida community. Deborah Beasley LaFave faces 5 counts in connection with her alleged relationship with a 14-year-old boy.
All the contact has been sexual in nature.
Police and sheriff's officers in 2 counties tell CNN LaFave met the boy at the school where she teaches, Greco Middle School in Temple Terrace, a suburb of Tampa. They say the boy was not her student, but she approached him at various school events, and earlier this month they began having sex. First at her apartment, then inside her portable classroom at the middle school. Then, authorities say, the boy went on vacation at the home of his cousin, north of Tampa in Ocala, Florida, and LaFave followed him.
And the teacher traveled to Ocala from her home and met with the student and also his cousin. And some of these activities took place in front of the cousin.
The activities in question, according to the Marion County Sheriff's Office, sex in the back seat of an SUV on at least 2 occasions while the boy's 15-year-old cousin was driving. Police back in Temple Terrace were notified after the 14-year-old told his parents of the alleged encounters. Temple Terrace police contacted the Marion County Sheriff's Office, and Deborah LaFave has now been booked on 4 counts of lewd and lascivious battery and 1 count of lewd and lascivious exhibition. She's been released on bond from both counties. Her attorney spoke to reporters this week.
There is a presumption of innocence in this country for anyone charged with a crime, and we hope that everyone would listen to that.
In the Marion County Sheriff's probable cause affidavit, the boy told detectives that LaFave was, quote, turned on by the fact that having sex with him was not allowed. Hillsborough County school officials tell CNN Deborah LaFave is now on administrative leave with pay. Brian Todd, Washington.
Upbeat consumer news had investors cheering today.
Yes, and coming up, we will have the closing numbers on Wall Street for you. Plus, a setback for people who want to limit growth in this fast-growing Placer County city.
And Starbucks, you bet, is joining the Battle of the Bulge with some new drinks. We'll tell you about that coming up.
Gene Wilder's a psycho CEO.
I'll fire me. Stein, you're fired.
You can't do that. I just did.
Next, Will and Grace.
Tonight at 11 on Fox 40.
The
Simple Life 2 is the season's smash hit, and Paris and Nicole's trip is right on target.
We love animals, as you can see.
We love to grill them, fry them, barbecue.
Then things heat up.
This is like a fireman thing, right?
When they take over a Mississippi fireman's calendar shoot.
Breathe a face like you love it.
The Simple Life 2.
Wednesday at 9 on Fox 40.
Chevy Silverado half-ton extended cab. Compared to Toyota Tundra Access cab, you get more horsepower and more towing capacity. Now, current GM owners get 4,000 loyalty cash on most 2004 Silverado models, or qualified buyers get 0% APR financing on most Silverado models. Chevy Silverado. Turn the key. Start a revolution. See your Northern California Chevy dealer.
McDonald's and Sony Connect are hooking up for the greatest music deal in history. Every time you buy a Big Mac meal, you get a free song. Just go to connect.com to get your access to hundreds of thousands of hot tracks.
For a quarter century, Tia Rosa has been making the most delicious, authentic tortillas available. For great Mexican flavor, try Tia Rosa. Tradition you can taste.
We are insomniacs. Insomniacs. While other car companies sleep soundly at the wheel of convention, we have created a dream machine.
Created a dream machine.
An all-wheel drive vehicle with a stunning new body and a turbocharged soul. A vehicle that takes your old notions of a wagon and puts them to bed.
To bed once and for all.
The 250 horsepower Subaru Legacy.
Rise and shine.
See your Subaru dealer for details on a special introductory lease on the all-new Subaru Legacy.
The Fox 40 Business Report is brought to you by Caltronics Business Systems.
A somewhat quiet but good day for the stock market. Here's the deal. The market got a boost from a big jump in June consumer confidence numbers. The increase comes despite the Fed's expected interest rate hike tomorrow. The Dow gained 56 today to 10,413. The NASDAQ is up 15 to 2,034. Taking a look at stocks of local interest for you, Gencor, which owns Aerojet, was up 14 cents. Hewlett-Packard added 12. Sherwood Communications rose 42 cents. And Target lost $1.75.
A Placer County judge ruling a growth-limiting initiative will not be on the November ballot. The citizens group Friends of Roseville fought for the initiative, calling to limit the growth of Roseville outside its city limits to the west in what is now unincorporated Placer County. The judge ruled the initiative had several defects and lacked vital information. Eight Rockland families have a solid foundation tonight thanks to the help of Mercy Housing. A dedication ceremony was held this afternoon to celebrate Oak Court, a community of eight single-family homes built for low-income families.
Now we just don't have to worry about being forced to leave because of, you know, certain situations that you can get into renting. And just to have a great neighborhood to raise our kids.
These eight families had to work hard, though, for the chance to own their own home. From start to finish, each family had to commit at least 40 hours of labor each week, in addition to a full-time job.
Tomorrow, Starbucks begins offering a new line of low-cal drinks using lower-fat milk and artificial sweeteners. A 12-ounce version of the new Frappuccino Light will have 140 calories and 1.5 grams of fat. The original has twice that. Now, if you don't care about calories, the largest traditional Java chip Frappuccino has 650 calories. That's 50 more than a Big Mac and 25 grams of fat. Now, for you traditionalists, a basic cup of coffee, nothing added, has 10 calories.
Temperatures out there tonight, 60s to near 70. Breeze continues. That's going to keep us cool. We'll have details on that and your holiday weekend coming up.
All right, Pat, also ahead tonight, a multi-state mega jackpot was up for grabs.
Also, a giant termite invades Sacramento, and it can actually help you learn new things.
Bob, where are you?
Boise.
Boise? Where's my proposal?
I just sent it to BizHub.
BizHub?
BizHub's in Boise?
BizHub is next to your office.
Near the fax machine?
BizHub is a fax machine.
I need it in color.
I printed it in color.
But you're in Boise, Bob.
I'm printing to BizHub from Boise.
You've got a BizHub. We all have a Biz Hub.
Surprising versatility and amazing affordable color. That's Biz Hub from Konica Minolta.
Biz Hub, available from Caltronics.
At GMC, we're offering our loyal GM owners and lessees $4,000 loyalty cash on the only full-size truck engineered to be professional grade. The GMC Sierra 1500 Extended Cab, with more standard V8 horsepower than Ford F-150 and Dodge Ram. Current GM owners or lessees get $4,000 loyalty cash toward any new 2004 GMC Sierra. Upgrade to professional grade. See the pros at your Northern California GMC dealers.
He warned them.
I swear to God, if I even feel somebody behind me, there is no measure to how fast and how hard I will bring this fight to your doorstep.
We got our guy coming across the street.
Warren is a guy with pieces to a jigsaw puzzle.
Take him down.
They should have listened.
I told you people to leave us alone.
He's coming for us.
This is Jason Bourne.
Trace it.
Where is he?
Right next to you.
The Bourne Supremacy. Rated PG-13. At theaters July 23rd.
Announcing Nissan's full-size July 4th sales event featuring the Armada, Nissan's new full-size SUV. Get a full-size engine, the most powerful standard V8 in its class, full-size towing up to 9,100 pounds, full-size capacity, standard seating for 8. For the first time ever, 1.9 financing for 60 full months or 1,000 cash back on Armada during Nissan's full-size July 4th sales event, now through July 6th.
This portion of Fox 40 News is brought to you by your local Cadillac dealers.
Fox 40 News at 10 continues.
The anticipation is building in 12 states tonight as the Mega Millions jackpot reaches $220 million. Plenty of folks in Detroit, Michigan getting out a buck for a chance at tonight's drawing. It's unclear whether or not there is actually a winner yet. The top prize has gone unclaimed since May 7th, rolling over to a higher level 14 straight times. It's still nowhere near the largest jackpot back in 2000, which was worth $363 million.
There is a woman in the Netherlands who apparently knows the secret to longevity. Hendrik van Andelschipper recently celebrated her 114th birthday. That would make her the world's oldest person, according to the Guinness Book of World Records. A choir sang, a band played at her birthday bash. Hendrik lives in a retirement home, and she says eating herring and drinking orange juice are the keys to a long life. Okay. Yum. Okay, now tell me if this isn't the biggest termite you have ever seen.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's not the real deal, and be glad that it's not. This inflatable towering termite on display at the Sacramento Zoo is 69,000 times the size of a real termite. Inside, you've got all kinds of exhibits to entertain and inform.
All kinds of interesting facts about things like from people from other countries eating them as a dessert or a treat. To the amount of damage they can do to the queen laying an egg every 15 seconds.
Busy. The towering termite, sponsored by Termite Control, will be on display at the zoo till Thursday.
Another great summer day to visit the big termite.
Seems like the kids really loved it out there. Question is, we're talking about all this mild weather we've been having. How long is this weather going to last? You know, we have a big weekend coming, a big holiday weekend. Pat Hambright will tell us if temperatures are going to warm up for you. His 7-day forecast is next.
ESV, the biggest, boldest Escalade ever. Cadillac, breakthrough.
Take advantage of 0% APR financing toward any new 2004 Cadillac Escalade model at your Cadillac dealer.
The best Chinese food.
And the best steaks are now at the best casino in Northern California.
Shanghai Fats Asia Bistro. Traditional favorites and the best of the Far East.
Austin Steakhouse. Prime aged beef, fresh seafood, and the incredible A-Bar.
Shanghai Fats. The perfect place for dinner and cocktails.
Austin Steakhouse. Prime perfect.
Two beautiful restaurants.
Priced just right.
Shanghai Fats.
Austin Steakhouse.
Only at Thunder Valley Casino.
From the dawn of time, there have been traditions. And mankind has always known it's just not a mix. without the checks. Now there's a whole new spin on caramel. New Chex Mix Caramel Crunch. With a salty sweet caramel taste and new crunchy caramel swirls. New Chex Mix Caramel Crunch. Get into the mix.
This summer, Fox 40 asks you one vital question.
Want to win a bet?
It's Fox 40's Want to Win a Vet contest, where you can drive away with a 2004 Chez Chevrolet Corvette.
I love that car.
To enter, watch Fox 40 weeknights from 6 to 8 and look for the two code words.
It's invigorating.
Then, log on to Fox40.com and fill out an entry form before 8:30 that night, and you could win an American icon.
Yes!
You can also enter at Chez Chevrolet in Stockton. It's Fox 40's Want to Win a Vet contest. Sponsored by Chez Chevrolet. Buy into it.
This portion of Fox 40 News is brought to you by CarMax.
And now, Fox 40 weather.
Hey, that Delta breeze really did a nice number today. We dropped some 10 to 12 degrees in places out there. And it looks like this cooling trend is going to continue for a couple of days. However, outdoor plans for the weekend, we should get back on summer track. Here's those numbers out there today. Well, we were in the 90s yesterday. We were in the 80s in most of the valley today. Look at downtown Sacramento, managing 82 today out there. 67 on the coast, 70s to near 80 in the Sierra, where again, we had the clouds build up and again, we had showers and thunderstorms. But it was the Delta breeze that really did us the number. Take a look at the numbers tonight. Sacramento not seeing anything, but look back in the Delta. Still funneling in that cool air. And as long as we have that push, of course, we get the cool air in here. Takes us longer to warm up in the afternoon, and it looks like once again we're on track to see some more 80s out there. Cloud cover building up again today over the mountainous regions. You saw the blow off, the high thin clouds trickle over the valley as we went late into the evening today. Actually, gorgeous sunset out there. It's nice to get that kind of stuff. Gives us a little bit of the pinks and the oranges later on in the day. This feature right down here is what we're watching for tomorrow afternoon, and as it comes up over the eastern edge of the Sierra, it should make some bigger showers and thunderstorms. Some of those maybe will roll down into the foothills proper. You can see where the showers built up along the Sierra crest today. This particular complex up here in western Shasta and into Trinity counties did have some severe thunderstorm warnings. It went up around Weaverville today. Other than that, it was just, again, high clouds building up with scattered showers and thunderstorms. Should be a little bit more numerous tomorrow and maybe even a little stronger in places. Of course, the target time for that will be in the afternoon and evening, because as this feature trickles up through here, it's going to looks like empower those thunderstorms a little bit more for tomorrow. So other than that, pretty much the same thing we saw today with scattered showers, thunderstorms up in the higher elevation. As I mentioned, a little bit more numerous tomorrow. We'll see temperatures once again into the 70s near 80. It all depend on when the cloud cover does move in tomorrow for our reporting locations. Good bet, though, you're going to see some thunder, lightning, and rain up in the higher elevations. The question is going to be how far down the hill that stuff does move for tomorrow. Go with mostly sunny in most areas, but again, you'll see the clouds building off to the east, and 3,000-4,000 foot level you might get a few raindrops tomorrow as those thunderstorms move a little bit off to the west. Now, as we head out to the coast, low clouds and cooler temperatures with 60s to near 70, 80 degree temperatures as we go inland. Breezy, though, again, as that Delta breeze continues to funnel in the cooler air, which will once again keep our temperatures in the 80s, below normal for this time of year. But what the heck, we know the warmer stuff's on the way, so you might as well enjoy it while you can. Downtown Sacramento tomorrow, a little bit warmer than we had for today, but with that Delta breeze, still nowhere near mid 90s, or as I said, even 100 degree temperatures. Those are going to hold off. That's the feature for tomorrow. Still enough energy keeping that Delta breeze in place for the next few days. However, as we go into the weekend, it looks like we will warm up a bit. So outdoor barbecues, evening activities, won't be too chilly out there. Looks like a pretty nice forecast. Get the cool stuff during the week and warm stuff on the summer weekends to enjoy summer activities. We like it when it works out that way.
It'll be a hot fourth.
Should be nice, though.
But if you're in a shaded park,
you
no
know,
problem.
It's hot in 4th of July.
Have
just
you noticed
together.
It's always something with these two?
Yes, there's no perfect.
Babies.
It's always
you know
what?
Good cop, bad cop.
There you go.
Thanks a lot, Pat.
I'm sure some of you agree with us.
7:45 tonight, I was at my desk thinking, you know, I'd love to see Mike Tyson fight.
Just Mike out Tyson, of the blue. Seriously, isn't Mike Tyson like a train wreck?
He is.
You cannot help but look and see what's going on.
Yeah, there's right? always something Absolutely. Going on.
Tyson's coming back. That's one of the stories in tonight's Sports Report. Plus, the first big NBA deal of the summer, Tracy McGrady. He's the how good is this guy? Look at this move by T-Mac out at Arco Arena against the Kings. He's tough. He's going to Houston. We've got the story coming up next in sports.
CarMax.com has over 20,000 cars online.
so you can get actual prices, photos, and descriptions of over 200 used BMWs, over 4,000 SUVs, and over 3,000 used cars and trucks priced below $10,000.
So if you find one that you like, you can have it transferred from anywhere in the country to the CarMax store nearest you. CarMax, the way car buying should be.
Dodge June bonus days are almost over, and now you've only got 1 week to deal. Get an additional $1,000 June bonus cash for a combined cash allowance of up to $4,500 on select models for qualified buyers who finance through Chrysler Financial. Or get 0% financing with $1,000 in bonus cash. Plus, with 1 week to deal, come in now and make no monthly payments until 2005. June bonus days are ending, and you've only got 1 week to deal, so get to your Dodge dealer today.
For 55 years, we as a people have had a national love affair with TV. Cowboys and cops, news and sports, sitcoms and soaps. Now, SBC customers can get it all from us. First the telephone, now home satellite television. Let us inform, enlighten, amuse, and entertain you. SBC, going beyond the call.
Forget the cookouts and the fireworks. This 4th of July, we're helping you celebrate your independence. So get to one of your Northern California Chevy dealers where current GM owners can get $5,000 loyalty cash on a 2004 Suburban, Tahoe, or Trailblazer. That's right, GM owners get $5,000 loyalty cash on select Chevy SUVs. This 4th of July, turn the key and start a revolution. See your Northern California Chevy dealer.
This portion of Fox 40 News is brought to you by your Chrysler dealers.
We do have some breaking news for you right now. A Modesto police officer involved in a shootout with a burglary suspect tonight. It happened about 25 minutes ago near the corner of Lancy and Manzanita. Now, we are told that the suspect was wounded and taken to a hospital.
And now, Fox 40 Sports.
All right, here we go with the big sports report. How do you think Tracy McGrady looks in that Houston Rockets uniform? Orlando did make the deal this afternoon. It is the first major move during the NBA summer. McGrady wears number one, of course, and he was the number one scorer in the league this past season, averaged 28 a game. He's been in the NBA his entire seven-year career in Orlando, but he said he wanted out, and this deal with Houston has been in the works ever since the season ended. It's McGrady, Howard, Lou, and Gaines to Houston for Cuttino, Mobley, Kelvin Cato, and, of course, Stevie Francis, who is the main guy going to Orlando. He's the guy also that held this trade up until today because he said he didn't want to go there. After he talked to the Magic people, though, he changed his mind and the trade was made. I guess they told him that they wanted him to be their guy. They want to build their team around him. I'm sure that probably helped convince him. Toronto picked Sam Williams today to be their new head coach. Played in the NBA for 13 years, past couple of seasons, and assistant coach with the Milwaukee Bucks. All right, let's do baseball. Giants go down south to play the Dodgers for three. They got beat tonight, but at least there weren't any fights. This time, Jerome Williams couldn't start because of a bad shoulder, so the rookie Noah Lowry started tough. He went seven innings, only gave up one run and struck out seven. Giants got a run in the first. LA tied it right here on the home run by Jason Wirth. And then with runners at the corners, Paul LaDuca, the Dodger hero, off Felix Rodriguez. That'll be a base hit to score one. 2-1 LA, that's the final. Big night for Randy Johnson, sitting on 3,999 strikeouts. Eighth inning against the Padres, he got Jeff Cirillo. 4,000 Ks for Randy Johnson. Nolan Ryan, Roger Clemens, Steve Carlton, the only guys ahead of him on the list. And look at this, he still got beat. San Diego beat Arizona tonight on the board, 3-2. Sean Burnett, the shutout win for Pittsburgh over St. Louis, 17-7. Philadelphia beat Montreal. New York beat Cincinnati, 7-5. 5-4, Florida, 7-5. The Cubs beat Houston, and 6-3, Milwaukee wins at Colorado. The A's then and the Angels, and Bobby Crosby's your Oakland hero tonight with the bases loaded in the eighth inning. That bats. A base hit off K-Rod to score two runs, and the A's went up 4-3. Mark Mulder pitched the first seven to get the win. He is now 10-2. Then he turned it over to Justin Lear, who finished a 1-2-3 eighth, and Octavio Dotel, who pitched a 1-2-3 ninth to get the save. Now that is just like a real Major League bullpen. 5-4. Final count. Oakland beats Anaheim. 4-3, Kansas City over Baltimore. Mike Wood, the former River Cat, his first win. How about that? 11-3, New York. In 11 innings, 9-7, Detroit beat Cleveland. 4-0, Toronto behind Ted Lilly. 6-2, Chicago beat Minnesota. Seattle over Texas, 4-3. And the River Cats, a winner this afternoon out at Raleigh Field. 6-2, they beat Tacoma. All right, talking Wimbledon here. We've been kind of keeping our eye on Lindsay Davenport to see if she can get her third Wimbledon championship. And you know what she said today? She said this might be her last Wimbledon tournament. Davenport against Carolina Sprem, both at the net here, and the reflex is working well for both. Davenport right there does get the point. She's only 28, though, and talking about not playing Wimbledon again after this year. Easier on the service point here for Miss Davenport. She will play Maria Sharapova in the semis, 6-2 and 6-2 today. And how about John McEnroe maybe playing the best match of the week in London on a barge floating down the River Thames. McEnroe hitting balls with Monica Seles. This set up to raise money for charity, and McEnroe played it up big time. Check this out. He even had one of his little famous fits, especially for the TV cameras.
Ball was in!
Ball was out, Mr. McEnroe.
Chalk flew up!
There was no chalk. The ball
you cannot
was,
be serious!
The ball was clearly out.
Can you imagine how many balls that you would hit in the water if you actually did try to play tennis on a floating barge? Hey, Tony Stewart in trouble with NASCAR again, this time for going after the rookie driver, Brian Vickers, after the race at Infineon on Sunday in Sonoma. This guy is always in trouble. He is just not a nice person, at least when he gets close to the racetrack. He didn't even want us to take his picture during practice on Saturday. Put his arm up, please. After the race on Sunday, went after Vickers, who was in his 25 car here. Stewart tried to punch him through the window. NASCAR says they haven't decided what to do with Stewart. I'll tell you what they ought to do with him, suspend him for a race or two. That would calm him down. And talking about guys with bad tempers, Mike Tyson, here we go, one more time. Announced today he is making another comeback. Even though he turns 38 years old tomorrow, Tyson hasn't fought in a long time since he beat Clifford Etienne in the first round of this fight more than a year ago. Today, he said he will fight a British guy named Danny Williams in Louisville, Kentucky next month. One of the questions for Tyson today, why haven't you fought for so long?
I don't know. I'm like I was saying before, when I make my mind up to make a fool out of myself, no one, it's gonna be hard for anybody to change it. I don't know. I just wanted to be foolish and not fight anymore for a while, I guess. I always knew I would come back eventually, but I just wanted to just have a chance to be a fool for 2 years or 16 months, I guess.
The story is, you guys, that he's supposedly broke. He has made more than 300, and I'm serious, made more than $300 million boxing in his career. Right. But as things stand today, he's supposedly almost $40 million in debt.
Yeah, we've heard
Can you
stories.
Imagine?
No, I can't, but no, you know, we've heard it with him.
Yeah,
incredible.
And you know we're going to be there watching.
The train wreck, right, Thomas?
Yeah, it is a train wreck. We love watching. Real quick, weather-wise?
Hey, it looks pretty nice with the Delta breeze the next couple of days. Then we warm up for the weekend, so plan on outdoor barbecues, sunscreen, and summer weather. Nice
forecast. Looking very nice. You like that one, Jim?
That's cool with me, but I know you guys are going to complain, one of the two of you.
We will after the show.
You'll complain about me.
That's all the time we have. Will and Grace coming up next, everyone.
Enjoy. Good night. We'll see you tomorrow.
Chrysler June bonus days are almost over, and now you've got only 1 week to deal. That means you only have a short time to get an extra $1,000 in June bonus cash for a combined cash allowance of up to $4,500 for qualified buyers who finance through Chrysler Financial. Plus, now through June 30th, come in and make no monthly payments until 2005. June bonus days are ending, and you've only got 1 week to deal. So head straight to your Chrysler dealer today.
Introducing SeaWorld Vacations. Everything you'd expect from a world-class theme park and everything San Diego has to offer. Go to SeaWorldVacations.com today. Your perfect family vacation is right at your fingertips.
Even close up, hair color should look natural. That's why today's Just for Men with X-Gray Science targets only the gray hair, replacing it with subtle tones that match your own color. In 5 easy minutes, vitamin-enriched Just for Men rejuvenates hair, brings back a natural look. No matter how close up she gets. Just for Men with X-Gray Science, the rejuvenator.
I really like the Amante. It has so much room.
Yeah, but I love the Sorento. It's got the four-wheel drive.
Well, I don't know.
May I?
Okay.
Oh. Somebody likes the Sedona.
Kia is doing whatever it takes to help you get into a new car, like offering $2,000 cash back and our 10-year warranty on the kid-friendly Sedona. Visit your Valley Kia retailers. Hurry, offer ends June 30th.
Watch Seinfeld at 7 and Everybody Loves Raymond at 7:30, weeknights on Fox 40.